Is Botox causing your dry eye? A common question, because dry eye itself is so common. We talk about lash serums, we talk about retinols, all the problems that they can cause around the eye. Watch my complete video on those. Botox is so common now, there are millions of injections done every year, and people just think it's a wrinkle reducer, but it does so many things. Now, the eye is one of the most common areas injected. The female, number one, is going to be the frown and the forehead. Men often come, the first sign is around the eyes. That's what bothers them. And people think it's innocuous. There are two main ways that it can indeed cause dry eye. So if you're working your way through dry eye, you're thinking makeup, irritants, retinols, you come off them for a little bit. Lash serums can change the color around the eye. They can help remove good fat around the eye that makes the eye look youthful. They can certainly change the color of the eye, but Botox is one that stops muscle movement. That's how it works. It stops the muscles. It also does things with the glands. It can stop oil production, but we're using it in wrinkle reduction. It doesn't magically make elastin, collagen, and things appear. It stops contraction. So around the eyes, I do it about once a year, once every 18 months, maybe twice a year here, but it's really around the eye where it will cause it. And there's two main areas. Number one is the crow's feet proper, and that's called the orbicularis oculi muscle. Very superficial injections. For trainers, you can go to myaesthetictrainingcenter.com or for medical professionals to learn these techniques. But most people just know, hey, I want those lines gone. The second thing we're gonna talk about is underneath the eye, but I'm gonna talk about that differently. But how could it, injecting over here for the crow's feet proper, change it? Well, because it stops muscle movement. When your meibomian glands, which are the glands along the lash line that we often talk about for hydration, they produce the most oils or tears, and it's a complex film that keeps the eye feeling soothed. When you really close your eyes, when you strongly close your eyes. That's why if you ever have irritated eyes, what do? You kind of blink heavy and boom, it squirts out those soothing factors from the meibomian glands. That's why it's very important to keep those glands healthy with hygiene, but you can't do it if we stop the muscle movement in the crow's feet or that orbicularis oculi muscle. So that's the first way. So keep that in mind. If you're getting dry eye, that might be something. Skip a treatment and see if your dry eye gets better and your blink will improve. The blink is important, and people think lashes, oh, they're just lashes, but also remember, lashes affect the airflow to the eye. So lashes are built, they actually have a reason, believe it or not, and that is to keep things out of the eye, like pollutants, like smoke, like particulate matter that's in the air, dust, pollen. But when they're long, they change the flow. So the eyelashes itself, you need that blink for them to work, and if they're too long, it changes the flow. So the dynamics of flow are important. But that's the Botox around the eye. The second area that can be affected is under the eye, and that is what we call the tarsal pad, and that's just below the eye. And sometimes people want that injected because they want the fine lines at the bottom of the eye, or the kind of the tear trough where people get fillers. They want that fine line gone. So oftentimes there's three, four. As we get older, there's multiple, and they find if you drop a couple units of Botox or neuromodulator, there's several ones: Botox, Dysport, Xeomin, Jeuveau, many in other countries, that it's those lines get better. And indeed they can, but think about the other thing it does. It stops that muscle from contracting, and you get open eye, a more of a blank stare look, which people do like, because a female eye is more round and wide open. A male eye is a little more of a beady eye, a little more of a closed eye, because that frontal bone in a male develops. You get a little frontal bossing, a narrower eye. But for a female, they might like that drop of Botox-like product here, opens the eye a bit, but in turn, a blank open stare, more wind flow, equals dry eye. Very complex, but that's another way that Botox can cause it. So that injection, whenever I do that, I do tell patients, hey, you might end up with dry eye if I inject there. They say, doc, I don't care, I'll use some drops. I love that wide open look, and it can help with that. And so that would be another way. So I want you to think of that. The way to test it, of course, is, again, avoid that Botox injection for one treatment. If things get better, you know it was probably from that. It's an association people often don't think about. Remember to watch my videos on lash serums that causes aging of the eye, retinols that can dry eye, cause dry eye, and you ask for videos on Lumify and Lumigan and different products that you're worried about putting in your eye and meibomian gland dysfunction. We'll do more of those videos coming up this year. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.